Creating popups and modals was always kind of difficult, because you had to use a ton of HTML and JavaScript code to make it work properly. But luckily, this changed forever when they added the new HTML dialog element, because they already have built-in JavaScript functions that do the work for you. This is Coding to Go, and in this video I will explain how you can open and close dialogs with just 4 lines of JavaScript code. And of course, we will also cover how to close the modal if the user clicks outside of it. To create a modal in HTML, you just need to use the dialog tag. Let's make this modal a login form. We create an H2 heading saying login and create a form with 2 inputs and a login button. To open this dialog, we can call the showDialog method in JavaScript. So first we have to get our dialog element using its ID loginDialog. And then we can call dialog.showModal. This will display our dialog in the browser. As we can see, it already has some basic styles applied, like this padding, a border, and a slightly black transparent overlay that covers the rest of the website. We can see how this works by inspecting the website in the browser. The dialog element contains all the elements that we declared to display our login form, but it also has this backdrop pseudo element. This is our black overlay. If you want to style this element in CSS, you can address it by using the backdrop pseudo class on the dialog element. For example, we can change the background color to blue to see how this works. It is as easy as that. But let's remove this again and talk about how to open and close this dialog properly. By default, our dialog should not be shown. So let's remove this line again. Instead, I want to show this modal when the user clicks a button. Outside of our dialog, in the normal HTML page, I create a login button. This button has a onClick function that we'll call showLoginDialog. This is our function that we have to declare in JavaScript. Function showLoginDialog. In here, we will call dialog.showModal. Alright. Now, once we click on this button, the dialog will be shown. And since our dialog is a login form, the website will be refreshed once the form is submitted. This will happen when we click on login. We can see this will automatically close the dialog because the website is being refreshed. Additionally, we could also add a cancel button which closes the dialog without submitting the form. This cancel button has to have the type button, because this will prevent the form from submitting. Now we have to give this button a onClick function. Close login dialog. Again, let's declare this function in JavaScript. And this time we say dialog.close. So these two functions are responsible for opening and closing the login dialog. When we click on login, the form will be submitted. We can see that the website refreshes. When we click on cancel, the dialog is closed without submitting, because we saw the website in the browser did not refresh. Now, one important thing is to close the dialog when the user clicks outside of it. To do that, we have to detect the event when the user clicks on anything except the things that are inside the dialog. When that happens, the dialog should call the close function. We can start by giving this dialog an event listener that detects the click event. Now the callback function will be dialog.close. This will close the dialog when the user clicks on anything. We will fix this in a second. We do that because the dialog is everywhere, since it has this backdrop pseudo element that covers the entire screen. Currently, it doesn't matter where the user clicks, the modal will be closed. Now the only thing left to do is to exclude the elements that are inside the actual modal, meaning when any element inside of this container gets clicked, the dialog should not be closed. For this, we have to create a div wrapper around the elements inside our dialog, because we want to exclude every element inside of this wrapper from the click event listener. Let's get this wrapper in JavaScript using its class. document.querySelector.wrapper. Now we have to change our callback function in the event listener. We need the event so that we can get event.target. The event.target contains the HTML element that the user clicked on, which is why we can create an if statement and ask if not wrapper.contains event.target. Only then we want to call dialog.close. Wrapper.contains event.target checks if the user clicked on one of the elements that are inside the wrapper. Only if this is not the case, we want to close the dialog. This should work for most of the cases. When we click inside the dialog, it stays opened, and if we click outside of it, it will be closed. However, there is one small bug we need to take care of. If we click on this part here, which is the padding of the dialog, it closes. This is not normal. As a user, you would expect that this padding is still part of the modal, so it should not close. The problem is, we are only checking for the wrapper's children, and the wrapper starts on this blue box. So this green part over here is the padding of the dialog, and by clicking on this, we will close the modal. The best way to take care of this bug is actually CSS. In CSS, we only have to select our dialog and say padding 0. Instead, we give the dialog wrapper a padding of 16 pixels. Now the padding is part of the wrapper and it will not close the dialog on click. This code works perfectly fine. But what if I told you that you can actually reduce your JavaScript code down to 4 lines of code? Currently we have 13 lines of code, but we can achieve the same things faster if we would use a more modern and efficient JavaScript syntax. Let me show you. These two functions do only one thing. They open or close the dialog. So we could reduce this by putting it in only one function to do both. Show login dialog. This function will get a parameter show, which will be either true or false. If show is true, we can call dialog.show. Else we call dialog.close. Now we can actually remove these two functions because we did the same thing but shorter. Everything depends on this value, show. We only have to change the onClick functions in the HTML code. When we open this dialog, we can say show login dialog is true. And when we want to close it, we say show login dialog false. This way, we turned 6 lines of code into only 1. Now let's reduce this event listener code to 1 line of code as well. Whenever you see a lonely if statement without an else if or else, you can use the AND operator to achieve the same thing. First you write the condition, and then you say double AND, and then what should happen if the condition is met. Our condition is not wrapper contains event.target. And what should happen? Dialog.close. So if this is true, this should happen. And that's it. If you enjoyed watching this video, you can always like and subscribe. And let us know in the comments how you think about this new feature. This was Coding2Go, and you learned how to control an HTML dialog with just 4 lines of JavaScript code.